Ranos here, and welcome to the episode of Space Engineers, where we're not doing a mod review, but a script review. A script I think is actually very useful. In fact, two scripts. And you may wonder why I'm back in Spartan armor. Well, Space Engineers stable version is caught up with developer version, so meaning my mod review world, which was originally... Oh god. Ah, the lag's already began. Oh well, we'll go through it with the lag. Since then, the Space Engineers has updated, so now I can use my mod review world in stable branch when it was originally saved in developer branch, meaning it couldn't be loaded in stable. Yada yada yada. Anyway, these two scripts we're going to be looking at are very useful for inventory keeping. In fact, one of them is the newest version of the most popular script in the game. Something that almost everybody uses. In fact, you probably can't find a build that doesn't use it. And it has a ship and LCDs. Doesn't have any LCDs, they probably won't have this script. Considering you need them for this script. In fact, both these scripts require LCDs. And they're quite useful. So, how about we go take a look at them? Oh my god, just saw the inside of my head. Okay! Anyway, as you can see, this is the automatic LCD mod. Well, script. However, this is version 2. Ooh, god lag. Which is actually a much slimmed down version. It's not as clunky and it's pretty well done. It works almost exactly the same as the previous one, but it kind of uses some of the new features for blocks to make it run better. So as you see, we've got the reactors. I don't even need all those reactors on. Hang on a sec. Turn off. And if you watch up there, you'll see they'll update. Well, they should do anyway. There we go. Yeah, all updated. Now, it'll seem like it's going slower than normal because of the heavy lag I'm receiving. No clue how to solve that. Yeah, the top LCD tells you power, that tells you what's using the most power, which is actually new to the script. That's just like a resource manager, resource, lots of resources. That tells you like oxygen tanks and stuff. Now there will be more stuff in the oxygen thing, because when it says no oxygen blocks found, it's talking about vents, because I specified it to say what vents are there, and if they're pressurized or not. However, this ship has no vents just yet, so let's gonna say nothing. You can even sell it to tell you which items have inventory. If you have it all clustered into one, or have it tell you how much each individual item has. But that script for that is different than that, and that tells you what blocks are damaged. Unfortunately, it will not tell you if armor blocks are damaged, simply because the script can't access such information. And this has a lot more stuff on it than I wanted. But this uses the work script, so it tells you if something's idle or working. You know, pretty useful. And there's an awful lot of features with this. Now, on screen now, you'll see the full guide. Well, I would just be scrolling through it. The full guide on how to fully utilize this script and how to configure it to whatever you want it to do. Anyway, now that we're back here, I will now show you internals. Now, let's go for more, one that's got a bit more to it. This one does. So, previously, you had to use either public title or private title when it was there to put in the script, and there's a special line you had to put in this section if you wanted to use the text that was there. But now, it uses this custom data slot. As you can see here, echo, that's the name, cargo, only show what's in that particular cargo container, same with that one, not that. But if you use echo without anything after it, it just leaves a blank line. It's quite helpful for splitting up certain areas. Like this one. So use echo in between them to separate them. And center just puts the text of your choosing in the center of the line. As we've got here, Oh yeah, that the damage one's very simple. All you gotta do is write in damage. There you go, you're done. Here, center ingots. Now, inventory list prevents it from automatically adding these titles. You know, in case you wanted to do it yourself, and stuff like that. And this is so as it only shows ingots, and that's for it to not show progress bars. And the S stops it from showing how much ore you got for that particular ingot. Considering if you're like B, you already have one set up for ore. Where did the organics come from? This one's also a little more complicated. That one blowing is actually rather simple. I'll blow that one. This one? Just pretty much the same code over and over again. When you put in power, it'll tell you how much power your entire vessel is producing. And it will divide it automatically between reactors, solar panels, and batteries. Power time tells you how much time you have left until you're out of power. It'll show just a line in creative mode since you have unlimited, so we can't calculate infinity. And if you were to put anything in these squiggly brackets, that would be the specific block that it would be showing you what power it's got. And the second squiggly one is the custom title. Otherwise, everywhere where it says fusion reactor, it will just say reactors. So, you know, it's a bit more organized like this. But how about we get to the more visually pleasing one? Which is this one. Now this comes from a different script, which will show you with images exactly which cargo container, well, what's exactly inside cargo containers and any other item. You just gotta write the name in. Like, oh yeah, you gotta put the LCD cargo for this one to work. In other words, for the other ones to work, you just gotta put LCD. I think the idea like this, so that the two scripts can't conflict with each other, it does help. Either way, you just put in the name of the item whose cargo you want displaying on the LCD screen. And that's it. That's simply done. This one, however, is the second one, which requires a bit more. But it just requires the name of the other LCD and the number of what order it goes in. You don't have to have it. I think that means they both show the same thing, I'm not 100% certain. But according to the Steam page, the scripter says it was optional. Because as you can see, it's the right side, although this looks like it's on the left. But if you're looking forwards, that's on the left, and that's on the right. And you can see. And now, in this next room, I'm going to show you it working on other things. I need a crosshair. Open. Whee! You see here. Come on! We've got some LCDs. Now these two, if you have two on assemblers, then one side will show you what's in it, well, this storage space it's using up. The other will show what it's produced and what's in its other inventory space. So, you know what it's got and what it's stuff. I don't know what I'm saying. And you can even do it with a refinery. You can see there. And on the arc furnaces, then, oh my, what do we have here? One is not yet showing up properly. But why is that? Let me show you. Because before this particular script to work, you must go down from debug all the way to monospace. This particular one will only work when you have monospace selected on the LCD. And it just tells you what's in it. Tells you what ore's in it, tells you what ingots are in it. Simple. But there is something else that you put on the page, which I haven't got working. And that is custom colours. Yeah, it didn't work. But I'm just wondering if it's just capitalization problem. Let's see if this is the... No. Although, I'm thinking it may be another one due to spelling differences. This shouldn't be the reason. But if you're in the US, then you won't have to do anything about this, but I think there may be a little problem. Yeah, that had no effect. Yeah, I copied and pasted that from the Steam page and it doesn't work. Not sure why? I'll fiddle around with it to figure out why it's not working, so, you know. And if you're curious on why it's not working, maybe just ask the scripter, maybe he knows. Because he has a screenshot on that page with a LCD with changed colours. So it does work, but for some reason, for me, it's not. Oh well, it's only a minor thing, it's not too bad. I like it the way it is. I like to put two different colours on those, though. Have assembly 2 one colour, and assembly... I put 2 on both of them. I think. Did I? Nope! I thought I put them both assembly 2. Whoopsie! Yeah. Now, as for who scripted these scripts, the automatic LCDs 2 was created by M Master, and the inventory viewer, who's that thing, was created by Speedy Gonzalez. That is how you pronounce it, right? And now there's another part I need to cover, which I should have sooner. If you want to use these scripts, you don't have to do anything up with the world or the server or anything, as it's a script and not a mod. What you have to do is plop down one of these and then insert your script. By something going here, edit, browse workshop, select the thing. Yeah, these ones are obsolete, don't use them. Oh wow. Wait a minute. Yeah, click that, click OK. Click check code if you want, but I usually just go to remember and exit because I always trust that it works. And then there you go, done. What? Oh. It wasn't fully visible. Me. And same with the other code. You will need one LCD, well, one programmable block per code. And then after that, you will need to go here. Then you need to go to custom data. Set up actions, and then you just gotta run them with default arguments. Now, while the automatic LCDs do come with various options for the arguments, but you'll have to read the page for that, because I don't usually use it. It's mainly for, like, simulating shutdown and boot up of the computers. And then you gotta put that so it repeats itself. The scripter for the automatic LCDs recommends putting it on 1 second intervals. However, in a previous video that you probably won't have seen it. It was with the other script where it was showing it like an item spinning quite quickly and the automatic LCDs keeping up with it. So yeah, I got it to trigger now, so, you know. I don't think that's what's causing my lag though. But for performance sakes, if yours was the lower end, stick it to 1 second. You know, just stop it from going funny. But either way, I will be putting a link for both these scripts in the description below, and for the automatic LCDs, I'll also put a link to the Steam guide page, so that you can easily get to the guide and learn how to use it. It's very easy to do, so don't think it's going to go over your head. Piece of cake. So, I hope you've all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.